Greetings to you, my brothers and my sisters at Akuse prison in Ghana. I bring you a message from the heart of God, all the way from the United Kingdom in London. Because God really loves you, and He's put this heart message just for you, right from His heart to yours. And the message is that God loves you. He wants to remind you of His endless, unlimited love for you. You know, most of the time, we look at our natural circumstance and our conditions and we question the love of God. But I want to read a portion of scripture to encourage you this very day as the Lord brings you the special message. And the scripture is from the book of Romans. So I'm going to get there and read. So Romans chapter 8, from 31 to 39, it says, "What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare His own Son, but delivered Him up for us all, how shall He not with Him also freely give us all things? Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died, and furthermore is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor death, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord." Brother and sister, Jesus really, really loves you. Nothing can separate you from His love, not what you have done in the past, or what you are doing, or what you are yet to do. He loves you. He loves you. And His word tells us in Romans chapter 5 that whilst we were still doing the bad things, whilst we were still sinning, He loved us, God, and gave up Jesus Christ to die for us whilst we were in our sin. Today, a brother or sister may not die for you when you're doing good. How much more when you're doing bad stuff? That is the greatness, the unlimited, endless love of God for you. So if God is offering you this love that is so free, how would you respond to it? I want you to respond. And the response is to open your life and say, yes, I want your love. I need your love and I love you back. And how you can do that is to accept Jesus Christ. Because the Bible says that God is love and Jesus is love, because Jesus is God. So open your heart and respond to Jesus by accepting Him as your Lord and your personal Savior. I love what Paul said in the book of Timothy. He said, the word of God is not bound. You may be in prison, but the word of God is not locked up. And it's facing you right now. Would you give your life over to Jesus? If you want to do so, I want to pray with you. So just pray after me. Say, Father God, I thank you for your endless love for me. I receive your love and I confess that Jesus died. He shed His blood to forgive me of all of my sins. I receive Jesus as my Lord and my Savior. Thank you, Father, for accepting me. And you know, the love of God heals. You may be in need of healing, your mind, your emotions, even your physical body. If you're sick, I want to pray with you. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, I commit my brother, my sister listening to me in Akuse prison to you. You are the healer. By your stripes, they are healed. Because of your love, you took their sicknesses, you took their diseases, you took their infirmities, and you freed them from them all. So I pray and I come against every mental insanity. I come against anxiety. I come against the hold of the enemy over their mind. And I break that hold from their mind. And I declare peace to their mind. Peace, receive peace and receive sanity. Thank you, Father. I thank you that the spirit of fear is leaving them right now. And I come against every sickness and disease in the blood, in the bone, any growth in their body. And I declare that they are healed. Be healed. Because you love them, you have healed them. Receive your healing and be blessed. Thank you, Lord, for healing my brother and my sister. And letting them experience your love, your endless love. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. A young Reverend Darling, again, I love you with the love of the Lord. And never forget, Jesus loves you. And nothing you can do about it. Just receive his love and live in his love.